A couple of upstate attorneys are weighing in on the deadly shooting this week of a lawyer in Pickens. News 4's Myra Ruiz has more.
Police say a client's ex-husband fatally shot Pickens attorney Redmond Coyle on Wednesday. Jerry Crenshaw then turned the gun on himself.
Apparently, he was upset over a divorce settlement between he and his estranged wife.
Attorneys say it's not uncommon for emotions to flare up in family or domestic law cases.
It's been a long time looking down a barrel of a 45 today.
Greenville attorney Dick Warder was held at gunpoint by a client's ex-husband more than 20 years ago.
His emotion was just extreme rage. He was mad. And as time went on, he became less and less mad.
Warder says Matt Palmer was upset the morning he was supposed to appear in court for a contempt action he had filed for his client.
He had told a number of people he was going to kill me.
Another family law attorney says state laws need to change.
It's a tough business. And what happened to Redmond Coyle, a tragedy, even the sanest of people become unnerved and at times unbalanced during a domestic case.
Jason Elliott says requiring couples to be legally separated for a whole year before finalizing a no-fault divorce is too long.
I think if the waiting period was shorter, it would speed the process up, and it would alleviate some of the tension of it going on for so long.
Elliott also believes mediation should be required statewide before going to court.
If compromise is possible, I promote that because in the end it helps. The client going forward, and it helps their family.
Dick Warder says he doesn't believe any changes in the law are necessary, but he says there are other ways to keep clients in check.
But I would think the warning would have to come from the family and friends of the person that's losing control.
Meantime, his office staff members are prepared with concealed weapons permits.
I don't like to think that I would have to shoot anyone, but I wouldn't be afraid to.
Warder knows he's lucky he did not lose his life, and his heart goes out to the family of Redmond Coyle, who did.
It's very much a personal tragedy for them, and it's tragic.
Myra Ruiz, WYFF News 4.